I offer my humble pranam at the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Welcome to a video lecture on computer programming using Scratch. In this lecture, I'm going to explain about this program. Write a program in Scratch to check a given number is odd or even and display a suitable message on the monitor. Okay. This is the program. So before watching this, try to watch previous videos, then this problem becomes simple. Now I'm going to explain this particular program using that tool, the Scratch tool. That's a software. Okay, I'm going to use that. So this is a tool. Using this, I'm going to write a program to check whether a given number is odd or even. We know that the program is nothing but the sequence of statements. Means how to place a block, I have to write instruction in particular sequence. Therefore, just I'm going to use means first I'm going to drag required blocks from this. Suppose I'll go for events. Then once if we click this block, we have to start executing the program. Then we need a variable because we have to type, I have to enter the number from the keyboard. Therefore, I'm going to create one variable called num1. Create this variable, that is num1 is ready. Then afterwards, we have to input the number from the keyboard. Therefore, go for sensing. Then I'm going to use this block as well as this block answer. Okay. Then afterwards, we need some operator. Operator, that is actually I need mod operator. I'm going to use mod operator as well as what you call equal operator. The relation operator equal operator. Then I'm going to use what you call the control statements, that is if then else block. Okay. Now using this and one more thing, I want to display some message, then I'll go for loops. Then I'm using this block also. This block, let it be. Okay. Using this block, I'm going to I'm going to arrange these blocks in a proper sequence to check whether a given number is odd or even. I'll start doing this, and one more thing, I will go to variable. Under variable, I need this block also. Okay, let it be. So these are the blocks required to write the program to check whether a given number is odd or even. Then the first step is we have to read the number from the keyboard. That's why we have to go for this particular block. Then whatever the numbers here, by default there'll be a message called what is your name, but I'm going to change this message, enter any number. Then once if you execute this block, it's keep waiting. Okay, it's keep on waiting. So after displaying this message here, it's keep on waiting. Then once if you type some number from the keyboard, that number goes to answer. Then we have to send this answer. We have to set this answer to where? To number one. By default, number one contains zero. Therefore, I'm going to use this block. Then here we have that variable num one. Then set num one to what? To answer. That is answer is set to num. Okay. Whatever the number we're going to type from the keyboard, that number goes to num1 variable, num1 memory location. Then afterwards, we have to make decision. We want to find where we have to check whether a number is odd or even. Therefore, we have to go for this. Here, I'm going to place first equal operator. It's a relation operator, this one. And here, I'm going to put this particular block. Okay. Then I will go to variable. Here we have num1. Then I'm going to find the modulus of this. Means I'm going to divide num1 by 2 only, it's a constant. Then we know that this gives the remainder. This particular mod operator gives the remainder. What is the what exactly it works? It divides num1 by 2. Okay. Then we have to compare the remainder with zero. I have to compare the remainder with zero. Suppose I'm going to divide some num1 divided by num2 means it gives the modulus. If the modulus, if the means in other words, if the remainder equal to zero, that indicates the given number is even number. Okay, then we have to display that particular message here. Okay, if the condition is true, okay, if the remainder equal to zero, then it comes over here. Then you have to display this message that is num1 is even number. So it's even. Suppose if the condition is false, then you have to execute this block num1 is odd. Num1 is odd. Then our program is completed. Okay. See here, once if you execute this particular block, it's going to display this message, enter any number. Then it's keep on waiting. Then we have to input some number from the keyboard. That number goes to answer. Then we're going to set that answer to where num1. Okay, whatever the information available in the answer, that goes to num1. Then here this is a if else block, control block to make decision. It's a branching statement. Okay. Now here there'll be a block modulator, modulo operator. It's going to give the reminder. Gives the reminder. How it works? So first it divides num1 by 2. Then after division, it gives the reminder. What is the reminder of this? Then you have to check. If the remainder equal to 0, that is nothing but even number. If the remainder is not equal to 0, that is a odd number. So just we can execute this program. We can go to full mode. By default, num1 is 0. Then I'm going to click on this. Then enter any number. Say now I'm going to type something like a 4. Say click on this. Num1 is even. Suppose once again run this. Then suppose I'm going to type 5. Okay. Num1, that's 5. Num1 is odd. The 5 is odd number. Okay. Suppose once again I will give type something like 25. 25 can give any number as you like. Say num1 is odd. Then suppose I will input 26. 26, then that is num1 is even. Then you can type anything as you like. Suppose I will type 255. 255. Say here 255. That is nothing but odd number. You can execute here also. Say click on this. That is enter any number. Suppose here I'm going to input 6. That is 6. 6 is even number. Then click on this. Then suppose here the 45. Enter. That is num1 is odd. So this is the way of writing the program to check whether given number is odd number or even number. The important logic is this. Okay. Read the number from the keyboard. So first find the modulus. First find the modulus means you have to divide this number by 2. It gives the modulus means remainder. If the remainder equal to 0, that is an even number. If the remainder is not equal to 0, that is odd number. So this is the way of finding the things. So thanks for watching.